today on the Robert Christian Show. Beyond the news headlines, we're going to be talking about $15 an hour. Is that enough to live on, or is that an insult? And in the second hour, the changing times requires a changing Congress. What is going on with the United States Congress, and why aren't they changing with the times? Or are they? That and more today on The Robert Christian Show.
Stand up, because they won't be able to sit down because of the burning in their butthole, every sodomite. That way we'll know it's a sodomite, because he can't sit down. He can't sit down. He's got a burning in his butthole. He's got a fire. He's got a flame coming out of his butthole. He's got a flame.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Robert Christian Show. We are now in the second hour of today's live show. I have been appalled by some of the news and some of the folks that make the news. But first, let's get back into the news. Before we actually get into resume the body of this show. President Barack Obama is demanding a better and cheaper version of the cable boxes that millions of Americans use to browse their pay TV channels in hopes of enhancing competition. The Obama administration pressed for changes to the cable box, the set-top box, by a letter to the federal regulators yesterday, according to multiple people familiar with the matter, which said that they would speak with the condition of being anonymous because the filing was not yet public. Obama's move effectively throws the full weight of his office behind the Federal Communications Commission, which has taken the lead role in trying to crack open the market for TV set-top boxes. Millions of Americans pay on average of more than $200 a year to rent their boxes from a cable or satellite provider. In other news, Bernie Sanders did something previously unheard of in the most recent CNN debate. He stood up for Palestinians and for Palestinian humanity. As someone who was 100% pro-Israel in the long run, Sanders said that we are going to have to treat the Palestinian people with great respect and dignity. For many, this seems a bit bizarre, as Sanders is asserting that the United States needs to understand the Israeli and Palestinian beliefs, ultimately resolving the conflict between the two. Citigroup Incorporated, their quarterly profit plunged 27%, dragged down by lower revenue from trading and investment banking, as well as the cost to shrink some of the businesses and to cover the bad loans made to the energy industry. The number four bank by U.S. assets also said on Friday, today, that it could incur another $1 billion in credit costs this year if oil slipped below $35 per barrel. In London, five terror suspects have been arrested in the U.K., an operation involving British, French, and Belgian authorities, according to the officials. Three men and one woman were arrested in the central city of Birmingham on Thursday, and one man was arrested at London's Gatwick Airport early this morning. The UK West Midlands police said in a statement. The Georgia Governor Nathan Dell, and he really has had it up to here with so-called religious freedom bills in his state, speaking out for the very first time since his veto of House Bill 757 last month. The state's Republican governor hopes that planning to propose a similar bill would be mindful, that these lawmakers would be mindful of the backlash that other states are facing right now, including that of North Carolina. after their governors signed such bills and bills very similar into law. He says that I don't want to go through the same process all over again. He tells the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. It is time to take a deep breath. I see what's happening in North Carolina. I see what's happening in Mississippi. And I would hope that these are the ones that are pushing for this, would not waste the city of Georgia and want the city of Georgia to go through this kind of scenario. Louisiana Governor John Bel Edwards Wednesday signed an executive order prohibiting state agencies from and contractors from discriminating against LGBT employees and others. Edwards said that his action was needed in order to rescind the anti-gay religious freedom executive order signed by his predecessor, Bobby Jindal, last May. Jindal's order prohibited the state from punishing anyone who acts in accordance with their religious belief, and that marriage is between one man and one woman. He just had to add that in there. Thank you, Jindal. The previous administration's executive I am rescinding was meant to serve a narrow political agenda, Edwards said in a statement on his website. As the so-called bathroom bills continue to crop up in states all over the country, mainstream media is starting to dig deeper and to find out where the onslaught of the LGBT legislation or anti-LGBT legislation is originating. CBS Evening News correspondent Dean Reynolds went to the Orlando, Florida headquarters of the anti-LGBT legal nonprofit Liberty Council, where the group's founder proudly took credit for the recent uptick in state-sanctioned bigotry. With the Al Forney Center moving toward purchasing the foreclosed World Missionary Church in Harlem, the congregation is intense and quite homophobic, perhaps. Their pastor, David James Manning, is lashing out wildly. The church is not going anywhere, Manning told MSNBC in a profanity-laced interview, who said so because, in quotation, he says, because faggots don't want to buy it. I believe that before this building is ever inhabited by any sodomite homosexual faggot group, he said, with men carrying babies in their balls and giving birth out of their assholes, before this building will ever be used by faggots, that is what he said. And then we have this.
He's got to have special asbestos diapers when God gets through with the sodomite. This is the word of the Lord. This is the prophecy of Almighty God.
Okay.
This is the Lord's word. This is the Lord's word.
Yeah, thank you.
And pastor, if you are a sodomite, God's going to have a flame coming out of your butthole. You're going to need an asbestos.
All right, folks. Hey, that is not even the tip of the iceberg. Gee whiz. We'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, if you like the Robert Christian Show, tune in every Friday, 3 p.m. And we are viewer supported. If you'd like to donate to help us to remain on the air, please do so at via PayPal at robert@robertchristianshow.com. All of the information is on our website. We'll be right back.
useless diaper. You better go and pray to God and ask God to heal you before this word cools down. You better ask God to heal you, and then you'll tell God, I'm going to preach against every sodomite. I'm going to preach against the sodomite maker, Barack Hussein Obama, the son of Satan. I'm going to become a sodomite slayer, like James David Manning up there in Harlem, New York City. I'm going to become a sodomite slayer. Otherwise, you're going to have a flame coming out of your butthole.
I don't know, ladies and gentlemen, why. To me, that is just, that's comical. You know what? We look at the religious right wing. We look at the religious right wing, and this is what you come up with. Good grief! So hey, let's listen a little bit more about the flaming geyser.
You won't be able to sit down. Okay. You will not. You're going to have to make, they're going to have to make special asbestos diapers. If you thought that AIDS was bad, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Okay.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
Yeah.
Until you see the flaming butthole. And that way we'll know who is a sodomite undercover.
Okay. A sodomite undercover. You know, that is ridiculous. And he gets the oomph for that. Good grief. You know what, folks, I don't get it. You know, I don't understand it. Because in America, in American media, too often you find and you have people that are so against the grain. You have people that are so out there, very hateful people, speech that is, I don't know. You go to churches around the country, and often you find messages of hate and of disgust and of discord. But then you have this. You have this man talking about this.
You will not. You're going to have to make, they're going to have to make special asbestos diapers. If you thought that AIDS was bad, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Yeah.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
Okay.
Until you see the flaming butthole.
Okay. Yep. Exactly. So the flaming geyser. Good grief. All right, folks, we shall return right after this. We're going to get into to more of the political agenda and even religious organizations, churches. Wow. Playing part in politics. I'm Robert Christian. Stand by. We'll be back.
You know, folks, there is more to a talk show than just sitting and listening to a talk show. You know, you can contact us 24 hours a day, 7 days a week in Seattle at area code 206-736-9688. And of course, our website, robertchristianshow.com. It is more than what you imagined.
I got a word of knowledge, a word of prophecy, and I want you, preacher, to use this word of prophecy wheresoever you go.
Yeah.
That God is going to put a burning.
Yeah.
God's going to put a cancer.
Preach on.
In the butthole. God's going to put a cancer in the butthole of every sodomite.
Oh, good grief. Okay, now, a question. For those of you that are Bible scholars, what kind of a message really is this? When it is a message that a perpetrated message that doesn't unite but equally divides, that doesn't bring healing, but ultimately talks about destruction and damnation. What kind of a religious fundamental would that be?
Every sodomite butthole.
Okay. And then you have this.
Everyone that practices sodomy from the day of this message will get cancer in the butthole.
You know, I don't know, folks. I laugh at that. I do. I think it's ridiculous. Well, folks, that is a completely unedited soundbite of this man. Completely unedited. Now, if we are going to have in this country, if we're going to have the far right wing hateful terminology and groups that perpetrate hate, rather than that endorsing love, acceptance, joy, peace, of which there is no law against those things, why are we having those messages? Why aren't people really focusing on what they need to focus on? Rather, it's always not, you know, if it's not enough that your pastors of these churches, they want to know what you're doing and in your own bedroom. But so does the political agenda. The political party, the Republicans, have, you know, they, you know, hey, if you're a woman, they want control over your own vagina. Well, come on, that's what it is. If you are a man, they want to know what you do with yourself. They want to make sure that, you know, I don't know. But ladies and gentlemen, there has to be and there is a better way. But then when you find this
right there, it'll burn and burn and burn.
Yeah.
You'll have to, the manufacturers will have to go into manufacturing chairs where people can stand up, because they won't be able to sit down because of the burning in their butthole.
That is what he said. Folks, I don't get it. And for anybody to decide that they want to believe a message like that, a message that is drowned in hate, and not a message that brings love and acceptance and joy, you know what? Come on. All right, folks, we are going to switch gears and talk about the Republican Party a little bit more, because, you know, there is an awful lot that I don't agree with when it comes to the Republican Party and why that they continue to do some of the things they do. You know, what
it's
do you think?
That way we'll know it's a sodomite, because he can't sit down.
Yeah.
He can't sit down. He's got a burning in his butthole. He's got a...
All right, and thank you very, very much for that. All right, wow. Well, folks, we are going to look at this. We're going to take a look, ladies and gentlemen, maybe a progressive look, but we are going to take a look at the Republican Party. And I really want to know, and maybe you will be the one, maybe you can be the one to stand up even against the Republican Party and tell the Republican Party enough is enough. Perhaps maybe that's what should be done. Enough of the bigotry, enough of the hate, enough of all this, enough of the special interest. It's time to get rid of Citizens United, getting big money out of politics. You know what? I think that we should, because it becomes a very unfair parallel. You have these political insiders and these political groups and businesses who spend millions upon millions of dollars on political campaigns and only if they specifically will agree with your platform. If you are completely anti-American, I wonder what company that is based in the United States would actually stand up and say, you know what, I'm going to support you for the office of the presidency. We're going to support you, and this is what we're going to do. We're going to give money to your campaign. Now, I look at this, ladies and gentlemen, and I want to know. Maybe I'm talking and preaching to a dead horse. But I really, really, really want to know, ladies and gentlemen, what on earth is going on? When these people continue to be able to be elected, these people continue on to do what they do, continue to be bought off by corporate media, by corporate giants, by the corporate welfare system in America that are bankrupting America. And has watered down the American dream for millions of Americans. And these are the companies that are able to get away with it because they donate millions into political campaigns and contributions. This is what you call the super PAC teams. I don't get it. I simply do not understand it. I don't understand why. That it is so imperative for these political candidates that are running for public office to, in quotation, to represent you, in other words, to represent corporate America. These are the companies that are taking great pride, great strides to represent you only as far as the ballot box is concerned. Their concern is not representing you. It never has been about representing you or your common goals and interest. Now, folks, I'm going to tell it the way that I see it and give you the rest of the juice on this show. I don't understand. I simply do not get this. As to how that these companies are able to do, I mean, I can understand some of these knuckleheads stay in office and remain in their seats in Congress. Look, you know, Americans, we get so topsy turvy, so upset, so hacked off at the political process, and only when it comes to the office of the President of the United States. Now, granted, that is a very important election cycle. But just as important, it is those that are in our Congress, those that are our senators, those are the offices as well. And we can't, let's not negate this. Let's not think, oh, you know, that's going to be somebody else's battle. Let somebody else deal with it. And I say, really? Is that really what it's about? Is that really what you want? Is somebody else to deal with it? And you know what, folks? They have said, and I got so tired of it, you know, let the states decide when it comes to gay marriage. Let the states decide. Let them decide. Yeah. Okay. That's all fine. But yet when it comes to women, it seems like these same people that are saying let the states decide on same-sex marriage, which now is done. It's a done deal. But now here they are continuing to harp on women and their vaginas. We'll be right back.
You're watching the... Robert Christian Show. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
For your kids. And you didn't have money to buy them. Then, in your mind, the spirit of Christmas and the spirit of giving. Then you'll know. Yeah, it's true. Those things happen in life. online at robertchristianshow.com, the only address that you need for true progressive talk radio. We'll be back, ladies and gentlemen, right after this. Don't go too far. And let your family, your friends, your neighbors know that we are on the air. Folks, we are back with the Robert Christian Show. It is great. It's an honor to have you joining us. And as I try to bring issues to the table that maybe you've been talking about, you wanted to know about, you have been a bit concerned about, and not just on the issue of Congress or presidential debates or the issue, the matter of politics in America. I think that America is groaning, but soon enough it is going to wake up, it's going to stand up, and it is finally going to say, you know what, enough of politics as usual. We have to do something better, because what we've been doing ultimately hasn't been working. We can't continue to do the same thing and hope for a better result. If nobody is paying attention, until something really breaks, something really happens, get the lowdown. I'm telling you what, folks, we're going to get into the juice of it. We've been talking about a lot of stuff. And I would encourage you, ladies and gentlemen, to let your family, your friends, your neighbors know that we are on the air when we are on for our live content. And so what is it to you? What is it that you either like or you don't like when it comes to American politics? You know, I think that America has become very lackluster over the last several years when it comes to politics. They either get very mad about it, very angry about it, they scratch their head and go bald over it, or they throw up their hands and say, I don't know and I don't care. But yet when we have leaders that act like total imbeciles, kneel a third grader on the playground, trying to be the big shot, really. You know, what has America come to? And is this what our custom is? In my opinion, America has become so accustomed to our politicians playing America as a fool. And we've looked at this and said, you know what, hey, it's grandiosis. You know what, folks, I'm tired of the blanket statements. Aren't you? I'm tired of the blanket statements that oftentimes that these candidates will give. They don't answer questions properly or timely or accurately. And so to find the ultimate truth, it oftentimes takes a little bit of searching. I'm not talking about soul searching, but searching online, searching media, searching newspapers, looking at magazines, looking at editorials, And then, of course, hearing these politicians straight away and having a good memory. A good memory as to what they said. Now, I am not I'm not happy with the things, obviously, that are going on in Washington. I think it is completely backwards. And a lot of people, you know what, the people that have known people for years, perhaps all of their life, too often end up having massive fallouts because of political unrest or because of political views. Or religious ones. You know, I was told not that long ago by someone that I have known since I was 15. When she just had found that I am a talk show host, that I've been in media for over 30 years, she suddenly said, well, that's okay, but I don't trust you. You know what? I'm not asking anybody to trust me. If they do trust me, I think that's great. That is something. Trust is something that is earned. And after 30 years, I would hope that I have some measure of trust within the community at large. Now, I'm not saying that I know everything that there is to know about everything. No, absolutely not. That would be ridiculous. But what I am saying is that, you know what, there comes a time in everybody's life that we need to sit back and learn. A time in everybody's life where we can sit back and we can look at the fiasco as it is unfolding and maybe for the first time decide to get off the freight train before it derails. That's the way that I look at the world of politics. What about you? You know, too many people, I'm telling you what, too many people are so upset. The world of politics. We'll be right back. Live from Washington, the Robert Christian Show. Visit us on the web at robertchristianshow.com. We'll be back. Stick around.
America, the final frontier. Is it being destroyed by corporate media? Is it being destroyed because our nation appears to be turning black and white, rich or poor, the haves and the have-nots? Tune in to the Robert Christian Show beginning at 3 p.m. on Fridays right here, because we have this and far more that is in store for our live shows. You want progressive talk radio? You want a progressive talk show? This is the place to be. RobertChristianShow.com, the only address you need. Pay us a visit online, would you?
Well, good day, ladies and gentlemen. Robert Christian here with the Robert Christian Show. On this Friday, we have a fantastic show that is on tap. First, we're going to be talking about Dementia 101, what you should know about dementia, what the news agencies are saying now about dementia, and, of course, the truth behind it. And in hour two on today's live show, we're going to be talking about the U.S. Supreme Court. And ask the question, is the court now standing in a biased predicament? Because the justices are not unequally divided. What do you think? Do you think that the Supreme Court now stands a much better chance of becoming extremely biased one way or another when it comes to American law and American politics? This and more on the Robert Christian Show. Tune in, folks, at 3 p.m. and visit us on the web at robertchristianshow.com. You will be glad that you did. The Robert Christian Show, we are back live with you. And I want to know what you think and what you feel. You know, folks, life is full of emotions. It's full of anger at times because we live in a society that is getting very angry and very quickly. We have seen thousands of protesters out in the streets of America protesting against Wall Street, police brutality. We've seen this. It's made the news. We've seen protests against the Vietnam War. We've also seen good times, happy times, and family. We have seen a new beginning in America, but we've also seen the ultimate destruction of the American trust when it comes to politics. I don't believe, and you know, this is my opinion, I don't believe that, quite honestly, I don't think that people trust their politicians. I don't think that America, that we trust our politicians or what they say as to be the record-breaking truth. I mean, if they told you the truth, perhaps that would be record-breaking. But you know what? I think that America is better than that. I believe that we all deserve the truth. We deserve to know what's going on. We deserve a Congress that is going to work for the American people, not against us. Wow. That's what I think. And before I forget, let me get out my mighty POW calendar. Upcoming on the Robert Christian Show, we have special featured guest Marilyn Redmond coming on. Jerry McMullen is also coming on. Lovely. Mike Negoda coming back on the live show. Movie director John Finch is coming on. He is the movie director, well, the producer, actually, of the Father Effect. He is also coming on. Ooh. That's going to be interesting to hear from John about that. John DeSette is also coming on. Wow. And then, you know what? And that's just on the live show. We've had a lot of guests, people just like you. We've had people like Ryan Hazy, a local music talent. We've had Michael Cagle on. We've had movie director Del Shore is on. We have had, oh my goodness, Miss Coco Peru on a live show. It's been great. We're doing stuff. We're going places. And folks, we can only do it with your help. So if you do enjoy the Robert Christian Show and you enjoy what we have to offer, you enjoy our content, then I would encourage you, ladies and gentlemen, to help us and support us. We need all the help we can get, actually, because being in this media and in this format, we often are in a battle royale, sort of, when it comes to time, when it comes to time restraints that people have, and you know, all this. And early on, we had changed the time of the live show, I believe, twice. We were at 10 a.m., then, as I remember, it's noon, and then we bumped it back to 3 p.m. On the West Coast. And, you know, we did it because, and people were, they got a little bit aggravated about it. They said, well, you know, you shouldn't do it at that time because, you know, there's another show on that we enjoy watching, that show. You know, so that's kind of where it is. We want to do this. And, you know, so as if I were, no. You know, I'm not in competition There is no match, no competition. If people want to be educated, if people want a good, solid talk show, if people want to get hell-bent, they can do that. But trust me, this is not the show to get hell-bent on. It really isn't. We laugh, we have a good time, we enjoy the news, we look at it with a grain of salt, obviously, but as we endeavor to look forward and to push forward in this media, we endeavor to push forward with what we're doing. You know, I do it, ladies and gentlemen, because I want to involve you. There is no sense in just listening to the news and not being a part of it. That is exactly what I think. So, what cranks your gears? What is it about you? What is it that you enjoy? Is the news a little bit boring to you at times? You know, to me, it can be. I'm telling you what. So here we do offer a little bit of everything, and we offer shows and programs, show ideas, and content that you're not going to find anywhere else. That's why that it is so important. It is vital. Right now, if you have never supported the Robert Christian Show, right now is the time to do it. I don't get paid to do it. It's not about me getting paid to do it. I wish that I did, but as it is, that's not quite happening. But we're making it. We're doing what we can do, 1 minute at a time, day by day. That's exactly what we're doing. We encourage you to be there for us, ladies and gentlemen, as we are for you. We'll be right back.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is Friday once again. And the Robert Christian Show will be live and on the air, ladies and gentlemen, beginning at 3 p.m. Pacific. That is 6 p.m. Eastern. Today we have an incredible and a powerful show that is on tap. And we want to invite you to be a part of the show. Join us live. Go to robertchristianshow.com/live. Choose Channel 1 if you are using a mobile device like a cell phone, iPad, iPod, whatever, and Channel 2 for PC and other. Folks, the Robert Christian Show, it is more than just a simple progressive talk radio.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen, with the live show, and welcome back. John Kasich making some news today. And why this is should this be a political stump for him? Should this be a political statement or something that should be covered in the news just because John Kasich said so? It's amazing. The out of the ridiculous file, John Kasich says that women who don't want to get raped should not go to parties. Now, is that really what he said? Hey, it made it to the news. Folks, I don't get it. Again, no matter how right-wing, how hateful, how bigoted, how ridiculous that some of these political yahoos and candidates are, and what they do, what they say, okay, wait, there's more to come. Oh, wait, there's more to come, because guess what? There is one more story here. This guy is going to say one more thing. You know what? It irks me. Even online, you know, folks, I know quite a few folks online, and but it sort of irks me when I hear stories that and people making comments on Twitter or even on Facebook, and they say, well, you know what? Guess what? I farted today. I threw up. I got ill. Oh, I had to go wash the car today. And then suddenly they get thousands of likes and shares over something so ridiculous and something so stupid and cynical. Hey, I just belched today in the car. And because of that, hey, you know, you're going to get thousands of likes and hits and likes and yay. Give me a break. You know, it's like good news always travels the furthest, the slowest. But bad news, you know, or ill temperance, that goes a long way very quickly. And I don't get it. Folks, there is always going to be a time in everybody's life, I believe, that either we're going to straighten up and fly right, and that we're going to get back, you know, as politicians, if that's what they're going to do, then enough of the politicking. It's time, really, to get back to the fundamental values of America. What was that founded on? What would our forefathers think? Would they be rolling over in their graves? Our ancestors, would they be furious over some of the shenanigans and stuff that we've done? Or would they themselves, would they be happy? Enough of the hell raising. You know what? We need honesty. We need truth. We need justice. We need hope in America. Not a divided system that is crumbling. It's time to repair it. What do you think? Folks, it is urgent. It is important that I know what you think about things, because it's a temperature check. I've always said that. I've made people a little bit frustrated when they'd say, you know, here he is doing his shows, but yet he has the audacity to ask me what I think about it. Well, of course, because I want to know what you think. Sometimes it is good. It is nice to peer into somebody else's mind, into their life, to hear from them, to see what they're thinking about, to see what makes them tick, what motivates them. What motivates me is the movers and the shakers in this world. You know, I've been ridiculed, I've been persecuted because of that very statement. People don't like it because I would say, hey, you know, I want to know, we want to know, we deserve to know the truth. Well, let's know the truth. Let's get motivated in our way of thinking, folks, that we can understand and we can see this thing clearly. The train wreck is just ahead unless we get a new conductor. And the conductor in this isn't the president. The conductor in this is our Congress and our senators. You know, a lot of people, they want to put the blame on President Barack Obama for everything. You know, I don't like him because he's a black man. Well, isn't that a little bit racist? Well, isn't that just a little bit unsavory? Well, I don't like this because of that reason. And okay. But they give Congress and they give their senators a free ride to continue on the same path that they've been going down. Folks, that doesn't make a lot of sense. We'll be back. Well, good day, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Robert Christian with the Robert Christian Show. Beginning at 3 p.m. Pacific time today, we're going to be going over some fantastic but incredible news stories, along with our featured guest today in the first hour, talking about HIV and AIDS, and is there a potential cure? Well, guess what? Scientists say yes. What do you think? And you decide. We're also following this news story as one of the stories today. In a lawsuit filed on behalf of several atheist plaintiffs, argues the phrase "In God We Trust" on U.S. money is considered to be unconstitutional and calls for the government to get rid of it. What do you think? Do you think that it is time to get rid of "In God We Trust"? I'm Robert Christian. Visit us on the web at robertchristianshow.com/live, L-I-V-E. There you have it, folks, and we'll see you on today's live show. Be there.
Hey, everybody, this is Ryan Hayden. Producer of Just Sing Already Season 4, and I want you to come out and audition. Not only do we have an amazing season lined up, but it is one of the best seasons that we've ever had, and it's going to be so much fun. We've got four amazing coaches to work with you each week, teaching you coaching, vocal lessons on how to become a better singer, as well as stage presence, and so much more. It's just like all of those TV shows that you've seen and those singing contests, you know, the ones not allowed to say. But anyways, come out and try out for auditions April 3rd, 10th, and 17th and 24th at the Box House in Pioneer Square. It's going to be amazing. This year, sponsored by Absolute Karaoke, Seattle's premier karaoke company. It's going to be absolutely incredible. We'll see you there.
So what makes your world go around? Do people really need a break? A break from stupidity, I have to say, absolutely yes. You know, the world is full of very stupid people, but I think that what has made people so ignorant, so stupid, so ill-tempered, so vile, is a phase of the actual dumbing down of America. Yeah, you know, I've used the expression "the dumbing down of America," and trust me, it is not laden with anger and with hostility, but rather with truth and with love. America, as we know it, has so changed. It has changed in its dynamics, it has changed in its policies, it has changed in its mission, and in its core value. And, you know, I love America, just like you. But I know that we have had very vital, but very radical change that has happened, that has taken place in this country over the last few years. And I'm grateful to see it. I'm elated to see that we have a president who has done exactly what that he had envisioned, but very saddened at the same time, because we have a Congress who simply don't care. We have a Congress who have been bought off. You have senators that are more interested in your sex and your sexual orientation and your role within that orientation. More of these yahoos are more concerned about women and their bodies than they are protecting and proclaiming love and peace, mercy, hope for an American society at large, of which that it's losing its dream. There is, and there has to be, something more. But what is it? And then where are we going to find this something more? I don't think that we're going to be able to find new beginnings in a voting booth. You're not going to find new beginnings and your dreams fulfilled by alcoholism or drug abuse either. I don't see it. I think that the American dream is dying. But there is something that, of course, that we can do about it. And that is to revive it. Investing, not divesting. There's that word again. But investing in our technology, investing in our infrastructure, investing in each other, investing in your friends, in your family. Those that have given up on you, and hey, they've said, well, you know, I would watch this, I would participate, but I don't trust you. What kind of a moral is that? I think, ladies and gentlemen, that I do not need to defend a truth, but to defend the truth. Stand up on a reality, stand up on a hope and a vision, on a quest. Because that's where it is. I get shell-shocked. I get upset, just like you do. Not just at the world of politics, but the ridiculous isms and schisms by a man-made religious fundamental that church and state should be together. How's that working for you? I'll be right back. You know, ladies and gentlemen, there are a lot of folks that we truly do enjoy seeing on the live shows. And you're one of them. If you haven't been paying attention to the live shows in a while, you have been missing a lot. And people typically do miss a lot when they're not watching the live shows. So we encourage you not just to like us on Facebook, not just like us on Twitter and follow us there, which, of course, we're happy that people do that, but to fall in to the Robert Christian Show. Ladies and gentlemen, it is more than what you ever imagined. We're doing things in this media that is so powerful and so unique in its own right. And we want to encourage you, and we want to have you join us in the fight for equality in media. Join us, folks, in the fight for true media and really what media should be about. And we can do it one day at a time, one person at a time, and that's where you come in. You know, you can always put it out on your Facebook and on your Twitter. You can always send out emails to let your family, your friends, your neighbors know that we are on the air. We are on the air, ladies and gentlemen, every Friday at 3 p.m. Pacific time. That is 5 p.m. Central, 6 p.m. Eastern. Right here for the Robert Christian Show. And if you just so happen to misplace where we are, remember robertchristianshow.com, the only address that you need right there, robertchristianshow.com. And we have the links for our videos. We have our links for our live shows that we do. They're posted on the website. So, hey, do yourself a favor and visit us online, folks, robertchristianshow.com, and we will see you on an upcoming show.